And I have the true value one too.
What's the, what's that, a Breast T?
Yep. Yes, that is with a mother-in-law seat. That's actually a Ford Model A. The first original.
The original Model A.
1905, I believe that one, I forget. Steel wheels. Well, I'll tell you what, you felt every bump in that.
How do you feel at the end of the day from...
Not good. Not good at all. Hey, let's stop here and see if they got Prince Albert in a can. Probably does. I'm going to look on the shelves if he has it. Pickle barrel. There's real pickles in there. Oh, look. There is pickles in there.
Oh, cool.
And apples.
Open the other one.
And nails. I have a keg of nails like that. Let's see, I don't see Prince Albert though.
Any good stopwatches under the counter?
I'm sure. Those are actually modern reproductions. Those are not originals. I don't see Prince Albert though. Oh well. Ain't got it, ain't got it. Seventh president of the Pennsylvania Railroad. Shine, mister?
Shine what?
Tommy, go get you. Yeah.
How much is a shoe shine? A nickel?
Yeah. Close clearance.
Talk about infancy of the railroad here. John Stevens replica.
Built in 1939. Cab, mister? Pennsylvania number 94.
We were
getting into the war. Yep. Talk about emblem. Oh, look at the woodwork on this one. Look at that. Civil War cannon.
We're seeing it. Wow. Yeah, does this look like a good, bad, and ugly here?
Yeah, it does, actually. Yeah.
Right out of the Civil War. Bob Webb's up there.
Yeah. don't think they get up there every day to clean them. Ouch.
You know that brass is polished.
Oh, yeah. Thoughts, Scott? Yeah.
Even the trucks are moving.
Yeah, I know. I saw that.
Like, the trucks are steel, where they're braced all over.
Yeah, they're braced, but they all wood.
Yeah, they got metal buckles and everything on their braces.
Damn.
Got another 6-7 years for the Civil War.
Yep. 1855. What is this?
This decorated sculpture is one of the surviving architectural fragments of Philly's greatest railroad terminal.
1881.
The Broad Street Station.
Hmm.
Wow. I wonder where it was.
I don't know, somebody probably took it home for a souvenir. Or well, they gave it to the museum early on.
Before it got the wrecking ball.
Yeah.
Same thing with Penn Station. Pink marble. And then they late and a dollar short.
Yeah.
Called this a globe valve.
Climb up the front of the locomotive.
It's on his desk.
I wonder what goes here. Almost like there's room for something.
Apparently they have the means to pull all this stuff in and out.
Oh, I imagine they got a switching engine somewhere. In air-conditioned comfort. Yeah.
Oh, so that's where that came from.
Ah!
I was wondering. Okay.
Activate switch to operate. Oh. stuck in the floor exhibits. See what we got there.
Look at this. The last bell, the last steam locomotive.
1952.
It was on the second floor. Open the elevator.
Elevator, hold up, people. Let's see if your luck with elevators is holding up. That's one. So we're on one. We need to press two.
Yeah.
Well, we're moving. We haven't plummeted into the sub-basement, as I thought would happen in the museum yesterday.
Another place Terry won't go. Absolutely not.
Doesn't like elevators, I don't know why.
You absolutely do not like elevators.
Oh, yeah.
Here.
Yeah, it's the company president's office here. Looks like my desk.
President's chair.
President of the Pennsylvania Railroad, I guess.
Not all the globe is.
For the new boardroom at the Suburban Street Station in 1930. That globe
and
is
all
old.
In car, look at that.
You can't read a single thing on it anymore, but it's there. There's all the big shots of the railroad, I guess. Photographs on the artwork. Oh, this is the boardwalk up top.
Including what's outside, but it's all heat and humidity controlled. I can't imagine this being too damn cold in the summer, but warm enough during the winter. My God, we're doing meticulous restoration on just one of these. Maybe not so much the hopper.
Oh, you can see into the hopper.
Yeah. The bottom opens up like Bombay doors.
Yeah.
So long sticking.
Yeah, I have one of those sticks.
But I mean, just even on the coal car, just do a restoration on that.
Oh, yeah.
Never mind something like that. Maybe the porcelain on the...
Yeah.
Or the ceramic, or the conductors.
Yeah. Yeah.
No chintzing on the paint, my God. Anytime, like you have the Danbury Rail Museum, everything's out there just rotting away. It was already in horrible condition when they got it. It's already twice as worse shape, you know? It's unbelievable.
This side, I can get some pictures, huh?
Dude, I had no idea this was like this. I just... Something new here. God, how the hell do you get this from one end of the country to the other? You
on
know?
Tracks. Basically, you drag it there on the tracks, I guess. That bit, do they have a special transport, set up. The railroads must have had them just to move them around when they broke down and were wrecked.
Take forever a day to get this from one of them, you know, somebody got one somewhere, you know. So it's just worthy to go in here.
Yeah. On this side, I can't take many pictures because I just... There's no light. I didn't bring my big flash. Even if I had the big flash, it wouldn't. Not this dark. What I get is a dark picture, so things like that. And there's detail, some of it, but it looks like it's a night shot, really.
Well, again, you know how bright you want it in here.
Yeah.
That thing has a skylight over there.
Yeah. Western Union.
These don't work apparently.
Why'd you hit it?
Yeah, both are coming and going.
Well, I guess they figured you're not in a wheelchair, so they don't open for you, that's all. I believe it. I believe it. What are you looking for, Scott?